I'm going to give you this opportunity. I don't know if you're going to take it. Okay, this is my setup. I don't know if you're going to take it. But to those in the football world who talk about stuff for a living and analyze things and opinionate for a living, what would you say to those people who maybe, say, had you on their show right after the draft that you traded Josh Rosen to Miami, and right after you hired a coach who had never been a head coach before, and went ahead and sent away Josh Rosen after drafting Kyler Murray first overall, and people wondering whether you knew what the hell you were doing? What do you say to those people? And I'm kind of raising my hand right now, Steve. What do you, I don't know if you're a football spiker professionally, but what do you say to those people, Steve Keim, right now?
I think it's a fair question. I mean, I think that the media has to do their job as well, and I certainly respect that. We were coming off a stretch of a couple years of football that I'm not very proud of. You know, prior to that, we won over 50 games in 5 years when we hired Bruce Arians as our head coach and I took over as the general manager. But, you know, you can't live on the past. And as Bruce always told me, who's a dear friend of mine, the elevator ride from the penthouse to the outhouse is a quick one. And it certainly was for a moment there. But, I think in this business, Rich, you have to put on blinders and you have to believe in what you see and you have to trust your instincts. And in those situations, moving on from Josh, which was tough, and drafting Kyler and hiring Cliff Kingsbury was something that I felt strongly about. And hopefully we can continue to reap the benefits.
And, you know, I guess instead of spiking the football, you kind of just handed the ball back to the ref right there, knowing that there's more downs to be played, I guess, Steve. When in this business also, we use phrases for guys who are particularly tough, a problem. And Kyler appears to be a problem for defenses in a manner that few quarterbacks can. Is this what you envision when you drafted him first overall, what we're seeing right now, Steve?
Yeah, because, to be honest with the process, I really did not want to like Kyler as a player because we had just drafted Josh the previous season, and I liked Josh Rosen. I thought he had a lot of upside.
Right.
But going into that pick, which when you have the first pick in the NFL draft, again, to me, you had to be honest with the process. And what I saw on tape at Oklahoma was a guy who ran the football and threw the football like nobody I've ever seen. And when I say that, I've seen guys who can run like him. I've seen guys who can throw like him, but I've never seen the dual threat that he can pose. And his ability to create with his feet is exceptional. We all know that. But his ability to throw from the pocket with accuracy and touch is also something I think is exceptional.
He's amazing, man. I got to tell you, he is amazing. And what he's been able to do in 2 weeks is nothing short of amazing. He's must-see television. He's so much damn fun to watch. And I have him in fantasy. What's it like to have him in real, Steve?
I mean, it really is. I think one of my kids said this. It's like watching a video game. I mean, he really is. It's, he eats up angles with his foot speed. He drops back. He throws lasers all over the field. He's competitive as hell. And he's just scratching the surface too, Rich. It's amazing because he just continues to get better and better. And as he learns to continue to use his progression, read defenses better, and get more acclimated to the NFL game, I just think the sky's the limit for him.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.